7 technicians who work from 118 different entities.
Bring that microphone up now.
That is the news on Barcelona City FM.
And welcome to Zest for Life Barcelona episode 2. We're excited to be with you, Vesna and Matthew here.
Hi guys, Barcelona City FM on 107.3.
We've got lots to discuss today. We're going to be talking with you. We're going to pull back the curtain today and tell you a little bit about some of the struggles that coaches can have. Sometimes people think, oh, coaches have it all worked out, and we just don't. So we're going to talk to you.
We still have
about
a lot
that.
To learn.
Exactly.
So we're not perfect. We're all human beings.
Yeah.
You know, and life is one big journey, you know, that you keep on exploring and you keep learning.
Yeah, so we're going to talk about some of our own personal health challenges. We're going to talk about some of the dynamics between she and I and all those things. So just stay tuned for that a bit later in the cast. For now, we're going to play a little bit of music for you, and we'll be right back after the break.
See ya. I don't think this mic is on. This mic is not on. I cannot hear myself. I don't know.
Oh, it's that.
Say. Hello? Hello? No. Ah, you put them down.
Okay. Yeah, of course. Yeah, but the thing was not.
I think this mic is connected to that.
Which one?
And it's she couldn't hear herself because that was off before, right?
Yeah.
And so I just put it on.
So I was talking, so they couldn't hear me.
No, that has to be on.
Oh, they couldn't hear
me.
Okay, got it.
Hear me
okay.
The radio.
Cool. All right, that's fine.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
So just say we had a bit of a
technical.
Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, just make sure the reds are on.
Okay.
Good. Thank you.
Now it's cool. Yeah.
We're good.
Thank you. Sorry about that. It's our second show, so just speaking of not being perfect, you see what happens.
What do you know? we'll be back in a moment.
Yes.
All right, so we're gonna go into new and good. That's what's next for us.
Yeah. You can actually turn on your iPhone and share it.
Where is it?
Share it. You can share it on my Facebook page as well, because you can post on my timeline and share it on yours. I think it's possible. Let's see who's. Well, Jim can join. Hi, Jim.
Oh, Danny's listening. It's okay. So how do I come back here?
Is it live? No.
Yeah, yeah, I see it. So I can do it. Hey, you want to figure that out?
Is it
compatible
in the página? Yeah.
And in a parking. Oh, no, is this for life?
So you can on our world or as a Matthew? Do you want it as our world or as a Matthew?
Matthew, I think.
I know.
Yeah. It's okay.
Right. I'll figure it out.
Yeah, it's fine. It's not so critical, but
I'm just going to put live with that.
Nice.
Okay.
Perfect. And then you can keep an eye on the comments there if you want.
Yes.
And then eventually we got to get this thing working, because that's the idea, is to look at it here, all the comments on this big screen. That's what they were saying. Next week we'll have that. Oh, wow. 1 minute. 1 minute.
Okay.
Just
and
I'll give you always like a minute and 30 seconds.
What's doing good?
Doing good, that's it.
Can't share it online. Never mind.
Seconds. At 15 seconds, I'll bring the microphones up.
Okay.
Microphone's coming up now. We were just rocking it here in the studio, moving and shaking to B-Boy Stance by the Freestylers.
You are shaking it, Matthew. I'm trying to figure out this Facebook sharing live videos on our personal pages. Because it's important for us that we have audience, and it's important for us that our friends, not just obviously the visitors and the regular audience from Zest for Life, that they see us.
Exactly.
You know, and because we're so passionate about what we do.
And we're still working out the details, like there's Facebook Live, there's video cameras in here,
Excuse me. We're excited to be with you.
We're gonna, on each of our shows, we're still working out exactly the norms of how we're gonna run our show, but we do want to let you know what's been new and good for us in the past week. We want to, you know, give you a taste of what it's like to be a coach and you know, do the kinds of things that we do. So, what have we done this week, Vesna? What was interesting?
For me.
Yeah.
So I started again with my gratitude exercise. So I would wake up first thing in the morning. So my routine is always like, first thing in the morning is warm water with half a lemon, fresh juice squeezed, and ginger juice as well. So I start with that, then I sit down and I write on a little tiny notebook that I have at least 1 to 3 things what I'm grateful for today or anything in life in general. So
that's your morning routine. It's like lemon with water and gratitude.
Lemon with water has been going on for months and months, in years. I do tend to take breaks from time to time because of the acidity to protect the teeth.
Sure.
The gratitude is something that I've started before. I stopped, and then I'm on it again.
Yeah. So if you guys want to comment, let us know how you start off your day to make sure that you're in a good space, a good mood. You know, if you want to share your thoughts, just do that on the Facebook live stream or on Zest for Life Barcelona. We'd love to hear what you guys do. You know, I do the same thing. I actually do lemon with water. Vesna and I were talking about this the other day. And, you know, what I've understood is that it's a really good way to wake up your organs after a long night's sleep where they haven't been doing much, and it kind of wakes everything up. And it's also alkalizing.
Well, it is, because the lemon is acidic, but obviously it is an alkaline-based fruit, so as soon as it enters our body, it turns into an alkaline.
Yeah.
And many of us have heard that, you know, the more your body is in an alkaline state, less disease, stronger immune system.
Sometimes we're going to geek out on the specifics of nutrition, so you'll have to let us do that occasionally. As we do, you know, we get two health coaches in a room, we start going pretty deep into this stuff. So that's great, Vesna. So it sounds like that's what's new and good for you.
And also, I've done much more yoga than I used to.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm getting more into the yoga practice and being more...
That's a perfect transition to what's new and good for me, because I did go to One Ocean Club the morning after our last show, and I practiced yoga there. It was fantastic. With the folks that do... We're going to say more about Suco later in the show. But these folks are organizing really cool events around Barcelona that are health and wellness related, and this was a really cool... You're on the port of Barcelona, not Barceloneta exactly, but that port that's near Barcelona.
It's the co-working space of the one co-work, port co-working club.
Yeah.
they do, I think they do like an unlimited classes for monthly, a price of 50 euros.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. And I mean, you get the benefit of the beautiful views first thing in the morning.
I think it might even be that your first one is free. And we'll find out the details and we'll post it on our page after.
Yeah.
I went for free, maybe because I'm on the radio. I don't know if that's what happened. But it was really, really nice. And the teacher was really, really skilled. And I enjoyed it a lot. So that was my new and good.
Me too.
Yeah. And I did also some more of those. Remember I talked about last week about those sun salutations that we did?
We mentioned some at the end of the show we mentioned briefly, I think. But
I did 44. I did 44 more of those today.
Yay. Well, today?
Yeah, just because 4 is my favorite number, I figured I'd do 44, and that's what I did.
Very good.
Feeling
very
strong.
Good.
So we're going to go into another, a little bit more. You always want to mix it up and play some music for you guys, so we're going to do that now, and then we're going to come back and talk about some more stuff.
See you soon.
Zest for Life, Barcelona.
107.3 FM. Can you hear us? Because I can't hear myself.
That's weird. Still
not. Were you able to hear yourself?
Completely every time.
No, were you able to hear yourself last time when you were sitting there?
headphones. Maybe try different headphones.
I don't mind as long as the audience listens, you know.
Try these next time.
The headphones is that where you're going to.
Oh, is it a different one?
No. All the headphones are plugged in here, but
okay, so it's still one.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, they're all It's plugged in everything.
Sure.
Yeah.
Do we sound good up there yourself?
Yeah, you sound good.
Okay,
good. Did you figure out the live stuff? Because you posted it on yours. I saw it on
mine. I posted it on mine.
You can't post it on yours.
So yeah, how do you come
because I'm like there,
that's my phone. So from there I cannot share it.
But that's live through Barcelona City of
Yes.
Is this your Facebook or is this his?
That's his.
So maybe I can share
it.
So maybe you should log in to your.
If you want.
I don't remember the password.
Because
it's on my laptop.
Yeah, I think the only way would be to get out of that.
And you can't share it from there.
She can log in.
If you log in on there, yeah.
Yeah,
I have
password.
To log in there.
Next time, bring the password. Cool.
Yeah, I don't know. Because, so you're live streaming onto our page, which is perfect, and then he shared it, so it's on his page, but it's not on your page because you can't share it, but you have to log into your Facebook.
Can he tag you?
Can he tag you?
You can tag me.
Yeah.
And then after it's posted, you can share it on your phone.
It'll be like the it'll still be like recording, but like not live. Yeah, I guess
when I tag people will see.
Yeah.
The next segment was supposed to be 1 minute. So the next segment was supposed to be what did you start your day off with food wise? So you're gonna ask me that what did I eat and then I'll go into my Do you test the headphones? Can you hear the music in there? No? Headphones coming up. Zest for Life Barcelona. Welcome back, everybody.
107.3 FM.
Here in Barcelona and live on Facebook Live. Barcelona City FM web presence for the Barcelona City FM is on Facebook. Like us there if you want to watch a video of us ongoing during the show.
Yes, and I'm just going to read a comment from Daniel Schumacher. He's like, dancing, love it. Thank you, Daniel. And Marcos Dimitrakopoulos, this is one of my neighbors because I'm from Macedonia.
Yeah.
Sounds like a Greek name. He's like, mention to drink water after the lemon juice, save your teeth.
That's perfect, actually. My friend Marcos' wife is a dentist, and so that's smart advice for a dentist.
Yeah. We didn't, I was actually going to say that, but I was a bit confused and worried whether the speakers are working or not before, so my mind was thinking of two things at the same time.
Perfect.
Hence the reason why I do sometimes breaks between the, you know, I do it for some time with the warm water lemon juice, and then I take a break to give a rest to my teeth. But yeah, it's good to flush them a few times afterwards.
Of course.
Once you've drank it.
Thank you, love you, Alexa. I appreciate that reminder.
Thank you, Marcos. Speaking of eating and drinking, what did you have for breakfast today?
So today, let's see. I literally had some crisp bread with some tahini, like some sesame tahini. And that's what I had for breakfast. And and then for lunch, I cooked myself some organic beef and some rice.
Mm.
Yeah, feeling pretty good actually today. That's when I eat those kind of things, I feel pretty good.
So you like your meat?
Yeah, if it's organic, I like in the home, I eat only organic meat. If I'm at someone's house, I'll eat what they're cooking.
Out of respect for the person making the effort and the love they've put in. Yes, exactly. Don't forget the love.
It's important.
It's all about love. Love, love, love.
Yeah. So good. That was my food for today.
Sounds delicious. Yeah. I love tahini.
Yeah, it's good stuff, right?
Yeah. I'll tell you one tip, actually, and to the audience as well. I mix in small little jars, right? Half tahini with half organic honey.
Okay.
Okay. And I take that in the morning, small spoon, with a fresh slice of ginger.
Okay.
It's so good.
You eat the entire slice of ginger?
Yes.
Wow.
But with the tahini, you don't really feel it. So the mixture of the sweet and the nutty.
And then the spice of the ginger.
And the spice and the ginger.
This is a professional, guys. Just be careful when you do that the first time. That's intense.
Yeah, you get spiced up. Listen to me.
Nice. Very cool.
When it comes to spicing things up, I know what I'm talking about.
She's a spicy Macedonian. Very cool.
Okay, back to health.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah. So you were going to ask me something about that?
No, actually, I might ask myself, what did I eat?
Yeah. What did you eat today, Vesna?
What did I have for breakfast? No, I had smoothie.
Okay.
I had spinach, banana, and orange. A smoothie.
And I want to know if people that are watching live, if you want to comment, have you ever had a green smoothie? If you haven't, why not? I want to know. Like, it's just so good for you, and you can make it really tasty as well. Yeah. So I want to know if you haven't had it, why you haven't. That's what I'm curious about.
It's so easy to prepare as well.
And we want you to know, we obviously know a lot about nutrition and health, but I've had recently some of my own challenges with digestive health. So I think we're going to talk a little bit about that even now, right?
Well, I wanted also to share my quinoa recipe. Today I actually prepared it so easy as well. Like, because, sometimes I think people don't cook healthy stuff because they think it takes a long time or it's too complicated. Sure. But it's actually really easy, to have a good sustainable lifestyle.
Quinoa especially is very fast to cook, right?
You can just fry separately with chopped few slices of onions and kale if you want, or some vegetables. Add a bit of sea salt, some seasoning, and throw it all together, and it's ready to eat.
Just one pro tip on the quinoa. The first time I cooked quinoa, I didn't rinse it first. It's really important to rinse it because it's got some natural thing that it's meant to deter the insects from eating it. So it's important that you rinse it, or else it tastes a bit bitter. Yeah, that's what I noticed. And usually when you buy it already from the store, it's been pre-rinsed. But if you are tasting something weird with your quinoa, that's probably what's going on.
Mm.
So there you go.
So maybe you choose where you get it from as well.
Yeah, I think that's all. It's all important. Yeah. Of course.
And speaking of eating, how is your digestion?
So for me, mostly my life has been, I've had a really, really strong digestion almost my entire life. Recently, I actually, when I was in San Francisco, I noticed there was some out of balance in my gut. And so I actually realized, I went to a naturopath and she did I'm going to share with the audience now, I did a stool sample. So I got my stool analyzed.
Get ready for poop time, guys.
Yes, it's poop talk. I've actually learned that there's like some imbalances. There's lactobacillus, I think, is the one. I've got the report here on my computer. But lactobacillus is the one. I have almost no growth of lactobacillus in my gut. And it's my first awareness of this. And I guess I don't eat a lot of yogurt, but I just didn't realize that it was out of balance.
Well, I would suggest you start eating some kefir then, instead of yogurt.
Yeah, kefir. Okay, what's the difference between kefir and yogurt?
Well, the kefir is actually a natural probiotic bacteria.
Okay,
it's like a fermented drink that you can, it looks like a little cauliflower.
Yeah.
Really? So you can do it yourself if you have the actual,
The original culture. The culture.
The culture, yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
And if you don't want to take a meat's milk, then you can mix it with coconut milk.
Okay.
Or originally it's made with goat's milk
because
that's the traditional way of doing it. Mm-hmm. But it tastes like yogurt, but it's not yogurt.
Oh.
It originally comes from Turkey.
Mm-hmm.
It's very famous in Turkey. And it comes from the word cave, which means good life.
Okay.
So kefir supports the good bacteria and promotes good bacteria within your digestive system.
Okay.
So it heals and nurtures your gut flora.
Good. Well, I've been doing that since I met this naturopath. I've been paying attention to how much of these cultures are getting into my system, and I am feeling actually better.
Excellent. I'm really happy to hear
that. Nice. What I really want to hear right now is the new Lana Del Rey song. Have you heard it yet?
No.
It's beautiful. And the video is actually really nice. They're on the Hollywood Hills sign. It's really, really nice. So let's play that.
Yeah, put it on.
Let's see what we do. Yeah.
Yeah, let's hear some music.
See you guys on the other side. That's for like Barcelona.
Alright, we're gonna get used to it.
It's weird, so
there has things. To be a way that we need to figure out of maybe me talking in again, so it gives you the space to put it in to start with the music.
On your jingle. She's amazing. So we'll do a jingle on the way back. Let's see. With the weekend as well. There's too many jingles. Like I don't know which. I'm afraid to play one that's wrong, so I don't want to do it. Oh, In Tune and Catch, let me that one. That's a good one. But I just want to see if I want something with the English In Tune and Catch. That's the driving. So I'll play that at the end of this song. Yeah. And so what's our next? So you're gonna go with your own. Where I'll ask you about your building and other issues. So fast. I can't believe how fast it's going.
I think we should tell your stories.
About what? Actually, it's really empowering when the masses of our own faith says something more about that. It's like a good message in the song as well. I just wish she wouldn't do so much plastic surgery. She's so young, it's like silly to me.
I don't know why people do that. Don't do plastic surgery, guys.
We're not fans.
Eat healthy food.
I mean, it's like, you know, I guess if someone has a strong self-image of themselves, there's really something, one thing about themselves they don't like, then I kind of think it's okay.
It's really affecting their self-esteem.
Yes.
And it really has a massive impact on their daily activities and daily choices they make.
Yeah.
Because it's always the back of their head.
Yeah.
And they've tried other alternatives of how to go about it and acceptance, but it just doesn't happen. And I guess, yeah, you know, maybe we can make an exception.
Yeah.
But becoming obsessed with something when you are already okay,
yeah.
You know?
And it's just the body, like it's literally your body. I mean, it's important to look good, obviously, but I think
yeah.
A lot of that comes from within, not so much. It doesn't have to be just on the outside. So. Yeah. You guys are hearing us, I think.
They can hear us. They can hear us everything. Yes.
We're never off.
Yeah,
we've
got
to be on the entire
time.
We're
never off. You're in the radio, you know? You're online. Like, look how many screens there is
like,
in front of us. Like, I'm buzzing.
All right, well, that's fine. Guys, I'm going to attempt my first jingle on the when we come back into the talk, so get ready.
Let's see, come on,
it's
good,
like
try.
We've got, like, how much time? 30 seconds, okay.
Oh, be careful, you. Keep calm and carry on.
Microphone is coming up.
And we are back, and I want to hear a little bit more about Matthew's story. How did this whole journey with your digestive system begin, and
yeah.
When did it happen?
So when your gut flora is out of balance, it can actually show up on the back of your tongue. And so I noticed on the back of my tongue some things that shouldn't be there, like white
naughty
stuff.
Naughty Matthew.
Yeah, and I was just like, this is not right, and I don't want this. This is not actually when I got to San Francisco, my sister was like, what's going on? So we started self-diagnosing on the internet and basically cut sugar. I was off of sugar for how long? Like 6 to 7 weeks.
Yeah, definitely 6-7 weeks.
Yeah.
Because I've been speaking with you, so yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
It's so good.
And it's gone. I just, so you guys know, I am kissable again. Like, it's gone.
Yeah, but I can touch him. Oh, you know, he's not infectious anymore.
But that's kind of where it started. And then we did the self-diagnosis, and then it was like, she's like, maybe you should see a naturopath as well. So I did go make an appointment with the naturopath,
mm-hmm.
and they said, "Why don't?" She's like, "I'm curious about the rest of your gut flora," and so we did a full stool test.
Ah, nice.
Yeah, and that's when I found out about the lower. So not only were these bad ones in my mouth, but the good ones are also relatively low.
Yeah.
So that was
okay.
Not good.
But now it's all recovering, and you're being conscious about what you're intaking, and like you're looking at your diet, and every day you're introducing more probiotic friendly foods.
Yeah. As soon as I saw the naturopath, I mean, she recommended I go on some supplementation, which I tend to not usually like, but this I was allowing because I knew there was something way out of balance. So I've been taking some pills that have a high amount of healthy gut flora, and I've still not eating the sugar. Basically, I've just had a very little bit, a couple of glasses of alcohol here and there. But not so much, and I'm enjoying how I feel. So there you go.
No, I mean, it's okay if you do have, you know, fruit from time to time.
Yeah.
That's, you know, it's all natural sugar. It's still fructose in the system, but
exactly.
At least, you know, it comes from a natural form, you know.
Yeah.
It's not processed sugar.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Now what about you? Because I know that you've had a history also. There was some bloating happening in your world.
Yeah, there was some bloating. There's lots of bloating happening in my world, you know. When we start talking about emotional stuff, there's always bloating happening with women,
okay.
I think, you know. So I find it so fascinating, you know. It's so complex, you know, the whole digestive system world, you know, and it fascinates me. And I'm really interested because it's so related to the way we feel and what we think, you know. Like, our gut is very sensitive to our thoughts and our emotions, you know, and they're very linked. So quite often, you know, like my girls will say, "Oh, you know, I was stressed out, you know, my stomach got bloated today," you know, or "you feel constipated." Women, they tend to, you know, and my clients, they tend to experience constipation. And I always, my first question is that, you know, what area in your life do you also feel constipated, you know, because there's always something linked with that, you know, that it's to do with it. It's personal relationships or some emotional issues from the past, some trauma, because stress, well, believe it or not, it's the major cause for disturbed digestive system, for, you know, disturbed gut, which is nowadays known as leaky gut.
Yeah.
You know, have you heard of leaky
gut?
I
have heard of it, actually,
yeah.
Is it also true that the gut is, there's also neurons or something? I've heard this about.
Yeah. There's actually more nerve cells within our gut flora than in our brain.
Mm.
So it's really like our second brain.
Yeah.
So it's important. You know, there's a reason why from back in the days, everybody says, you know, listen to your gut.
Yeah.
What does your gut say? Go with your gut.
Yeah, I think in most languages they have that kind of phrase.
And even like in spiritual practices, you know, there's lots of, you know, concentration on the solar plexus chakra.
Yeah, of course.
You know, you
of
know
course.
More about that.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
So, I think on the next talk, we might get into a little bit of a demonstration of what you can
yeah,
do.
Yeah, I'd love to show the people, of course,
yeah.
You know, and maybe tell them for the ones that they
yeah.
just listen on the radio, they don't see us live.
Yeah.
You know, how actually our body energies are interlinked and
exactly.
how you do that work. But speaking of the digestive system, yes, I have suffered with constipation before. I also had a parasite.
Mm.
Probably I brought the little guest over from India.
And when people say parasite, it doesn't mean there's one, it means there's many, right? There's
yeah.
like it's an infestation.
Well, I guess it starts with one or
and
more. That, yeah, it multiplies. But they tend to feed any type of parasites, bacteria, you know, something that is not part of your body
yeah.
tends to feed quite often on the sugar and gluten, you know. So sometimes when you're reaching out for that candy,
yeah,
if you do have, for example,
it's
yeah, exactly, it's not like the bacteria overgrowth or the parasite, it's not
yeah.
you, but it's the bacteria overgrowth or the parasite that it's making decisions for you.
Do you remember the name of this parasite? Do you?
No.
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 He had a name, or she, or they had a name.
He or she. The little monster is gone. That's
okay,
the most
important
thing. And how it was gone by, of course, eliminating sugar. doing bone broth.
Yeah.
What else did I do? Of course, drinking probiotics, and I would recommend that to everybody, whether you do have, you know, unbalanced digestive health or not. I think everybody should take either in a supplement form or a probiotic-rich food on a daily basis, obviously, to keep that, you know, gut flora healthy and strong, you know, to fight off infections and fight off different diseases. Because 80% of the chronic illnesses, they do come from leaky guts.
Yes. We want to be careful. When we say recommend, it's always important that you check with your whoever else you're working with, right? But what Vesna's saying is based on her personal experience and with all the people that she coaches, she also notices it's a common thing, right? That people are missing.
Yes. I mean, and we as health coaches, you know, we don't diagnose or treat a disease.
No.
We provide advice, support, and information that is, you know, suitable for the person's particular condition at that time, you know. So they make as well informed decisions what steps they need to take.
Yes.
So
for all the people out there that are feeling a bit under pressure, that's my subtle little hint for the next song that's coming up. We'll see you guys on the other side. My default will be to go, because I'm not present for the time, so I'm counting on you to look. So if you're, so either I'm going to have to trust you to tell me when it's time to go, the next song.
Don't worry, next.
I know we get like involved in the talking, and I'm not sure if you're aware of some time.
Don't worry, but allow me to keep on talking and give you this so you start preparing for the next song.
Good.
So I'm going to talk a little bit more about the gluten and my program.
Yeah, please.
And then another song.
Good. I have to learn how to trust that you're...
Yeah.
My experience that we're just talking, you're not looking at the time at all, so I'm like, oh, should you look? That's all.
Okay.
Cool. So we'll talk about that. We'll talk about... And respect that, so we're not. But sometimes the mouth gets dry when you're talking so much.
When you talk too much.
Yeah, we like to talk. So there we go. Right, so.
This is my favorite part when the transition goes with the song. You know? Yeah.
That's good. So did it stop?
Yeah.
Or is it back on now?
No. It's back on.
It is back on.
Yeah.
Okay.
We have to
be the whole time. That's good to know. No, that's what that's good.
I forgot that though.
Yeah.
So all this time we hear them.
Yeah, because T Bird was he doesn't do Facebook Live.
Yeah.
So.
Okay.
30 seconds.
Well, you can stop. Under pressure. Barcelona City FM, Zest for Life on 107.3. Guys, we are back and...
Welcome back. We were jamming out to that one in the studio here, just so you're aware.
I love that song, Under Pressure, you know. Yeah.
So what else did you want to say about your the gut issues? Because there seemed to be some more to your story there.
Well, I just want to point out that it's really important that you do have a healthy digestion.
Yeah.
You know, this is our life, okay? It's a small life from the inside, and every day we're bringing new stuff from the outside world into our inside world. So it would be wise that we are conscious about what type of things we do bring in into our digestive system, because this is what where excuse me, the hardest work is done, you know, where all the undigested particles and proteins and molecules and sugars and gluten, you know, are being properly separated, you know, and then they go into your bloodstream.
Yeah.
Okay, so for everyone who thinks that they need to improve or take it to the next level, their digestive health, you know, or they're experiencing symptoms such as bloating, unpleasant gas, or diarrhea, which is common for Crohn's disease, or sometimes even like headaches in the morning, feeling foggy and lack of energy, please contact me, you know, for health consultation.
How do they reach out to you specifically?
They can reach out to me through my website, which is on www.vesnagino.com.
Okay.
That is V-E-S-N-A-G-I-N-O.com. Yep, and on the contact session, they can just send a message and it goes straight, comes straight to my email, and we can arrange a free consultation.
Perfect.
And then we can discuss about my, you know, about my program. I do 3 months program of restoring digestive health.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we start with the gut, we see all the, you know, we begin with the gut issues, you know, first we focus on that, and then we look at all the other areas in life.
So some people want to go further and actually start getting into the emotional aspects and things like that.
Exactly, and if your digestive system is healthy, you know, then naturally, for those that struggle with weight, naturally the weight tends to drop off once you start changing, you know, the way you eat and the relationship you have with your food.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, it sounds interesting.
Yeah, it's very interesting.
Well, we'll see you guys on the other side. We're gonna play a little bit more music now. I know we're told never to say that, but I do like to say that. See you on the other side.
Now we're on time.
Good.
So when I do this, for the next time in future, put the music on already.
Right, and that
so
moment,
you're
saying in that moment.
So that way, you wouldn't feel the need to say, see you guys on
the
other side.
Yeah,
there's
already
the
there. It's
yeah.
like the music's already there.
Yeah.
Good, cool.
Yeah.
Cool, I like this song.
Okay.
Good.
So after
What's
this
next?
Music break, it's Get Real, We're Not Perfect.
Here we go. Good. Oh, what if, so this look, this is how this works. It just comes over here, like the mouse is here, and then it goes over there. So we would be here, we'd go on Facebook or something.
You can, there it is, Barcelona City FM.
Awesome show, guys, rocking it. Oh, it's so cute. How do I like go into it more, like see?
Thank you, Cheryl. I think it's Cheryl from Suco.
Oh. Oh, it is, yeah. I don't know how to like make it bigger.
That I don't know, but you can. I don't know. What if on the three dots? Yeah. Or maybe.
Maybe I just would do like another tab for Facebook.
Yeah.
Okay,
you gotta.
Oh.
Well, try.
Who's that?
I have no idea. I know. Do you remember your volume meter?
Sure. Where's it at? Where is it, Facebook? Do the at on this thing. It's there, but I can't get to it. Like at. It's not that, it's not. I don't know what it is. Maybe this.
What if you do the that?
Alt. Oh, maybe alt. Or alt and this and that? No. Oh, it's not in there now. Wait, hold on. No. No.
I would go back to Spotify and keep it.
Something
just
happened.
Leave this for now. If you open Spotify.
Okay, hold on, let me just close that.
Yeah, leave this for
time. Close it.
How much there's left?
45 seconds.
Okay, so I would probably open the mics now and start speaking with him.
Mic's going to come on at 15 seconds. I just put the mic on 15 seconds before the song.
Okay. I'll start talking while it's on the music.
Cool. Okay, 20 seconds.
Barcelona City FM, Zest for Life on 107.3 FM, guys. We have, how much time we've got left?
Not too much more time, about 17 minutes.
Wow, it flies so quickly,
it's
man.
It's incredible.
You know, get real.
We're getting real.
Are we getting real?
Oh, we're about to get real. So,
okay, go on.
Yeah, that's what we thought it would be good to, you know, just to share some of the times that we, like, before our first show, we were sitting at the cafe and we were just talking about, you know, what we're going to talk about on the first show and, you know, connecting each other.
We were pretty chilled. It was all cool in an organic place.
Yeah,
you know, he's like drinking his healthy smoothie.
Very relaxed. And then what happens? So what happened? Literally what happened is she just said something like, we should or could or some whatever you said.
I was just giving a suggestion, but yeah. I took both of us into consideration in the context.
And there's what I didn't really realize how intense the trigger was for me. I kind of know that I don't like when people do that, but in this, because I feel so comfortable around Vesna, because we're spending so much time together now on the air and, you know, we're getting to know each other more deeply,
I don't get too comfortable.
So I basically was like, you know, I don't like it when people say we. They don't, you know, they, when they assume that I think or feel something, I don't like it. And she said.
But you reacted.
Yeah, like my whole demeanor changed.
Like his whole body language changed, and he was like, well, you know, I don't like that, or I don't want, or I don't need it. Something that was so sharp that literally I felt like a knife in my gut.
Yeah.
Speaking of the gut.
Yeah.
Seriously.
And she thought, she even said, she's like, I was gonna like leave. I was gonna start crying. It was like intense. So we want to share this with you all, because just to show you that, you know, whatever, like I actually have a lot of communication skills and coaching skills, and I know how to express myself, but there was this trigger in me, which I felt really comfortable with Vesna to speak about. So we did, and we ended up, well, of course, we were fine. We came on the air and everything was great. And it's touched off this whole series of conversations in my life for me to learn more about what that's about. And maybe in a future show, I'll share more about that.
Well, I mean, to keep it simple, is basically we had a misunderstanding. In a normal situation, or what quite common happens between people, that, you know, like there will be a tension and it will just stay there. You're holding on to that energy, you know, onto the anger, or the resentment, or the, you know, the unpleasant feeling. So you're either going to leave the situation or continue arguing to make it worse. But we were able, and I guess maybe because we are into the health coaching world, we are always trying to see everything as an opportunity to heal.
Exactly. It didn't hurt that we had to be on the air like the next day. So, you know, it's important for us to be, for our dynamic to be really clear and clean so that we can present for you guys.
Yes. So we were able to actually, you know, step outside from the situation and to, you know, discuss it. Okay, so why did this happen? You know, where is this coming from? Because I can see in you that, you know, I triggered something, I pressed some button. You know, I know that it wasn't intentionally directed to me, you know, but of course it does affect me because you're reacting in a situation where I'm involved.
Yeah.
You know, so it was really good for Matthew to look into past life experiences.
Yeah, in this, not other lives, like this life.
Like this life, but in the past,
yeah,
you know, and the experiences and where this has happened before, what's the pattern and where originally it's coming from. And this is what we tend to do with our clients as well, because everything is linked.
Yeah, it's like we talked about last week, there are aspects of psychology which come in. We're not licensed that way, but we do indeed deal with maybe where things have come from before.
Yeah, so, you know, it's important, you know, that every time, you know, you do have something that you feel strong emotion, to always ask yourself, okay, you know, why do I feel this way? Where is it coming from? To really be able to step aside and observe.
That just goes extraordinary.
Yeah, it's better now, it flows.
It feels weird to me to do it, but I think you're right, it's better.
Yeah, it flows.
And it just leaves them kind of like, oh, they want a little bit more. That's also good.
So,
those are still on.
We're not perfect.
Okay.
So we're a little bit ahead of time. That's like 4 minutes ahead of time. But we can talk more about Suco.
Yeah.
You can read this, what they're doing, what's the price, and blah, blah. And
yeah.
What's this question for Donia?
Oh, we're going to see if there's any questions on the live stream. If not, because we didn't do the breath thing. We didn't do the SR.
We can do that, right?
Yeah, we could. That would be cool, actually.
Just a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, tell what it is all about.
Yeah, let me get that up here. His talking points. I want to, when we come back, I want to welcome everyone back because I want to say my friend recommended I play this song.
Yep.
So I'm not welcoming back. An old one, but I like it.
I don't know if there's more people there. So. This keeps getting off, so I don't know to check how many viewers. I think there's over 500 people that have seen it. That have seen it. Or
okay.
Seen it.
Cool.
We'll see now. So it's like 955 people it reached.
See, that's way more than we would have gotten.
Yeah. On the email, what was he saying about the numbers? Because I didn't understand.
Let's talk about that after. I don't know.
Okay, so there are some.
What's going to happen is we're going to do three areas. We're going to do upper chest, here, and here. Okay. Just going to bring your hand. And we're just going to see where you feel most connected right now. That's basically all that's going to happen. And if you don't feel connected in your gut, I'm going to say, you know, what we would do normally in this situation to find out if there's any emotion that she's not feeling. And I'll just talk you through it. It'll be quick.
Barcelona Zest for Life on 107.3 FM. We are back and I want to try some of your treatments.
Zest for Life, Barcelona. Yes. I just want to just shout out to the Bentera Negra, my friend Cedric, who recommended. I said, do you want any requests? He said, you know, Camusi. I was like, oh, that guy from like the 90s? And then I remembered this song and I loved it, so I did play that for him.
I love my 90s.
It was good. I liked it.
Yes.
So I thought we would do, just because we were talking about the gut and its connection to emotions, it's a little bit hard on the radio to do, but for people that are watching on video, it'll be easier to see. Vesna's going to be, she's just going to put her hands on her upper chest right now.
So I'm your guinea pig right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, both hands on her upper chest.
Okay.
And you're going to breathe in the nose and out the mouth. And just notice how connected you are to your body. Can you be present where your hands are? One more time, just notice. And I know this is a little bit boring for radio, but if you're watching on video, it's a little bit more exciting. Just keep breathing. And then bring your hands down to your belly button, both hands, and breathe in there, in the nose and out the mouth. What do you notice, the difference between the two places? Where are you more focused, more present in reality?
Right now, I feel it more in the belly button.
Okay, you're more present there. So maybe because we're talking, so what would happen is, so in this technique, which is called somatorespiratory integration, it's one of the techniques that Donald Epstein has created, and I'll say a little bit more about that as we close out the show. In this technique, you are looking to see if you're able to be present with yourself in different parts of your body, and there's a connection between your body and your emotions and your thoughts and other things as well. So we were just checking to see, and I was curious to see if she... So she's got a pretty strong connection right now in her belly button, which means she's connected to her gut and her emotions.
Yeah. It's excitement.
Yeah, she's excited.
Yeah. I think it's excitement and maybe a little bit nervousness, obviously, because we're live on air and it's
course.
Our second show, but it's a good feeling.
Yeah. So, I'll talk more about this as we close out the show and a little bit later. But So I just wanted to, you know, just give you guys a sense for different ways you can connect with your body. If we're talking about body and emotions and thoughts and things like this, and this is one of the ways you can actually do that as an applied technique.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, I've done it with Matthew before, and I find it really useful. So, you know, if you want to explore more within that area, then you can contact Matthew.
Are we going
to
have one more break and then come back?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
So I'll talk more about it after the next music break. Yeah. Cool. Good. So I'm going to play. What do people want to hear? I want to know what they want to hear.
I don't know. What do you guys want to hear?
Well, I've got
comment.
The love, so I'm going to play the love.
Okay. We gotta get used to it with the signs when I'm giving you, because I made you twice a sign.
What? Just now?
Yeah.
It's really hard to be focused on,
facilitate.
It's a different brain of mine to facilitate you.
Or maybe we have a little flag that we use,
exactly.
You know, maybe here,
Cool.
So after this is the closing, where you can talk a little bit about that. Then what's this week that we're doing, and next week is Suko. And it's perfect timing for you to end with a song.
Okay. And what's going to be our final song? Let's see.
6:44. Didn't you play You've Got the Love before? Didn't you play You've Got the
Love? I played another bit, Spectrum.
Okay. I don't know. What do you have there?
I can do Hey Now. Oh, my God, that's one that you said.
Yeah.
Cool. So that'll be the one that we go out with.
Okay.
Who's coming in after us?
No idea.
Okay, cool.
Maybe nobody. Because normally we need to mention them.
Maybe ask. We still got a minute and a half, so. Be a recording.
I don't know, but when the last tune is on, we're just gonna call out to help us and tell you something.
Perfect.
So
we've got about a minute.
Within 30 seconds, I would say you start, because it's 55. It gives us 3 minutes to talk, and then we've got the last song.
Okay, cool. Welcome back, Zest for Life, Barcelona. So we're going to wrap things up here already. We're getting close to the top of the hour. I want to say just something about the work that we very barely touched in just now.
Yep.
Was called somato-respiratory integration, which is one of the many modalities that Donald Epstein and Wise World Seminars offers around the world. And they really offer embodied energetics that access organizing rhythms of life. There's a spinal application, there's personal typologies and energetic applications. There's a whole, they're going through a big reorganization right now. It's a particularly dynamic state of evolution for that group, and it's one of the techniques that I've used for 15 years with myself, and I've taught around the world with people. And
it's so interesting.
It's very, very powerful stuff. It's magical. So if you want to know more about that, you can comment in the Facebook Live stream, and I can tell you more.
Even though I have done it with you, I still would like to do more, like learn more about it.
Yeah.
Well, I still haven't finished your book, so that's another thing.
Well, that's, we'll have to talk about that next time. Okay.
Well, I've got plenty of books, I really need to take one step at a time.
He's a busy lass. And now, what are you going to be doing this week? I'm always curious to hear what we're going to be doing between the times that we're on the air. So what are you up to?
Tonight, I'm going for another yoga session with Yomu, which is yoga and live music, my teacher, Lucy Ball. And next week, I'm really looking forward. It's on the 6th of July, which you are, of course, invited, both of us invited. It's on Thursday, the 6th of July. For those of you that are based in Barcelona, we've got Suko session.
This is called Suko, and Suko stands for sunrise, sunset, I think.
Yes, sunrise, sunset. And I'm just going to read basically what they represent. It's a unique disco conscious workout. And the sessions are designed for people to connect, to feel free, to have fun and let go. So the idea is to exercise your heart, body and soul, How beautiful
I
is
like,
that?
I mean, it's hippy-dippy, like, but that's the kind of thing that I get into. I like
but
it.
But, like, I mean, isn't it awesome, like, to have a safe space where actually, you know, like, a 10-year-old kid and a 50-year-old woman can connect together just through the music? So they start with a yoga session of 1 hour, and after is just loosening up with live music. I went on the last session, it was on sunrise, and I absolutely loved it. It was a great way to start the day. This time is sunset session, and it's going to take place at Park Citadella on
Ciutadella
on 6th of July, Thursday, starting at 8:15.
Fantastic.
So the early bird price is €12,
okay,
and 15 obviously afterwards.
Okay.
But for more information, you guys can look at their website. It's www.sucosessions.com. Suco as in S-U-C-O.
Check it out, and we'll be there, which is going to be, it'd be nice to meet some of you if you're going to be there.
Yeah, and there, I've got some surprise for there as well.
Fantastic. Are you curious about what I'm going to be doing?
Yes.
Well, let me tell you.
I'm always curious what you're going to be doing. You're always up to something.
I don't know if everyone's aware. It's in Barcelona here. It's Pride has begun. It begins today. And it's going to be going, it's like goes for a while. It goes for like a week and a half. And so on Sunday, July 2nd, which is that this coming Sunday already?
Yes.
Wow. So there's going to be the Pride Sport Day. So if you want to get more information about that, it's all about sports and activities that are related to LGBTI, all those things, of which I include myself in that community. So there's an event. If you want to know more, it's pridebarcelona.org to find out more about that. pridebarcelona.org.
So don't forget to see, to go to pridebarcelona.org for those of you who are interested in those type of events. I'm sure it's going to be loads of fun. I'm sure you're going to love it. Barcelona never ceases to disappoint people.
Happy Pride, Barcelona. Happy Pride, everyone in the world.
Hey, no. Did I say right now?
That's it, it's 19. It's fine. Okay, bye,
Love you!